Are you prepared for a serious cuteness overload? We have a very special treat for you in the form of Adira and Akasha, Dreamworld's 14-week-old tiger cubs. Oh my goodness, look at them.
The most exquisite things you have ever seen.
Look at those enormous paws.
Who's this first one?
This is Adira.
Adira.
And then Akasha. And we're also joined by their handler, handlers Patrick Martin Veig and Dreamworld's General Manager of Life Sciences, Al Mucci. Thank you so much for being here.
Is this Akasha?
Oh my goodness.
She's a little bit bigger than this one.
Yeah.
Can we pass them?
Yeah,
give her just on the back.
Oh, she's licking my shoe.
Can I stroke
just
her?
Just there. Can I put
her?
Now they're from Dreamworld, aren't they?
And yes, I'd love to. Oh,
she's biting a tiger cub. She's biting my shoe.
Look, Jack. Oh. Look. You might want to check your shoe.
Have a look at that.
Oh. This is a once-in-a-lifetime thing, I think.
Hello, beautifuls.
Oh, now, my goodness. So they're only 14 weeks old.
That's right.
They're pretty big for 14 weeks.
And they weigh about 14 kilos.
Wow. And the parents, they were born at Dreamworld?
They were born at Dreamworld. Both their parents were actually imported tigers from Europe.
Yeah.
And were brought out to Dreamworld for breeding.
And their father is Raja, right?
Raja.
I had a private audience with Raja. I was very lucky. About a year or two years ago.
That would probably have been Rama.
Was it?
Yeah, Roger is not one you'd want to probably have a private argument with.
Eyes closed.
I wish you could see the face that is just... she's got her eyes closed and she's like this.
So, Al, just hearing them go munch, 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 do they... they obviously need a lot of food and sustenance and...
Yeah.
Yeah. How much are you feeding them a day?
That's Patrick and
Okay. They're eating about a litre of formula a day and about 200 grams of meat.
Only 200 grams.
And that will be going up as they're getting older.
Mm-hmm.
And right now they're gaining about a kilo a week, so they're putting on quite a bit of weight.
So do you allow their parents to look after them, or do you have to basically intervene the whole way?
Well, we hand-rear them from about the age of 2 weeks.
Oh, no.
So in order to have them have a life where they can do a lot of different things.
Gorgeous.
And can do a lot for conservation, which is what these guys are, great conservation ambassadors.
You know what I love? Their white bits on their... there he is.
I think I just got a love knit.
I'm not sure that you're going to be able to...
Here, quick, get your baby.
I just got bitten by a tiger cub, and it's the proudest moment of my life.
And you talk about the role that they play in conservation.
Right.
Why is it so important? Because, you know, how many of these beautiful creatures are left in the wild?
Well, that's a good question. There's only about 3,000 tigers left in the wild.
Oh, my goodness.
If you go back 100 years, there were 100,000 tigers in the wild. So these guys are crucial in fundraising and also getting people aware of the fact that there are so few tigers out there and we need to protect them.
Now, will they stay as part of the tiger project?
But it's Tiger Island, yes. They're a permanent member of the family. They're born there. They've got an older brother who's 7 months old, and we have two new cubs that we just got recently that are going to be their adopted sisters, and they're going to have a great time with them.
Can I ask, what do they weigh now?
Right now they're weighing about 14 kilos.
14 kilos. What will they end up weighing?
Probably 130, maybe 140 kilos.
Wow. Well, you're going to be a big baby, aren't you?
Do you think I'm the biggest cat person in the world? I just adore pussy cats.
It's true.
And I'm wondering if I could maybe take them home or adopt them. Would that be possible?
You can adopt them. Doesn't mean you can take them home, but you can adopt them, which actually helps their wild cousins.
So
we have an adoption program, and these guys are part of that. It's a great present for people to give as well.
Hey, look,
and
I love what he's doing with
all
the funds that come from that
go straight to the projects in the wild we're supporting.
Oh, that is exactly what I do with Rob Squirt at the end of every show as well.
Just get rid of them.
Look at him crawling all over that.
Gorgeous.
They are the most... I'm speechless almost for the first time in my life because they're so divine. And I'd love... You can't pick them up, though, or cuddle them. I mean, obviously, you fellas can. But,
Jess would love to do that.
And when do they go from being this kind of playful and cuddly to, uh-oh, they're going to bite my arm off?
Well, we start raising them at that early age, so we can't work with them through their entire lives. But I won't be able to pick her up when she's 130 kilos.
Yeah.
So that'll be a problem.
You are.
Cheeky Chops, beautiful.
Oh, what a fantastic program as well.
So just remember, you can adopt, but you can't take home, and it goes to all the conservation.
But we also accept donations as part of the Dreamworld Wildlife Foundation. So Dreamworld Wildlife Foundation is the world's largest zoological contributor to tiger conservation.
That's wonderful.
So this little Aussie theme park on the Gold Coast contributes more than other zoological institutions across the world.
That is remarkable. Please thank Patrick and Al and Adira and Akasha. Oh,
and I think you're doing very well as mums and dads.
Yeah. More of Studio 10 right after the break. Stay tuned.
No more shoes.